Hey everybody, welcome back to the Dane Bramage Rocks channel. Okay, so this one, I'm going to be doing a reaction to the band Voyager, and this song is called Ultraviolet. Now, I discovered Voyager like a lot of people did by watching the Eurovision Song Contest of 2023, and they had their big hit release, Promise, that was written specifically for that that contest, and I was such a huge fan of that song. I'm still jamming out to it today. It is still one of my favorite songs from that contest. Good hard rock jam. Voyager is an Australian prog. I think they call it prog, like progressive metal band. So it's one of those where they do soft lyrical and like almost a soft rock, and then they get to hard and heavy. So kind of just transition back and forth between each song. But I'm just a big fan of the band, and I know they're starting to gain steam and get more followings. They just released an album not too long ago. I'll put the information up on the page because I don't have it memorized. But they released a song about a month ago, and it's called Ultraviolet, featuring Sean Harmonis. I'm not sure who that is, but I'll find out in the wrap-up and deliver all the information to you. But without further ado, I love Voyager. I want to continue supporting them and spreading the word about their music and who they are. So this is their song, Ultraviolet, that came out about, like I said, about a month ago. And I just dig right into it, all right? All right, here we go. Okie dokie, got about a four-minute song here. Like I said, Voyager, Ultraviolet, featuring Sean Harmonis. Sean Harmonis, let's check this out. They are. Simone. Gosh, she's such a... So at the very beginning, I heard that was a solid bass line that was being put on there. Boy, already a minute and a half in the song. And so, see what I mean? It started off slow and kind of soft, and it kind of picked up a little bit. If it's Voyager the way I know Voyager, they're going to do a deep, heavy, like... Maybe even a scream session on this. It's going to last a short while, but already... Good jam. I love his voice, and I just the bass is really standing out to me on this one. It's interesting. I hope Simone breaks out into something big, and I hope for sure that Keytar comes out. Here it comes. Okay. A little heavier, okay. I'm trying to hear what he's saying. They're saying he does want to be ultraviolet, and they're talking about violence. I wonder if this has something to do with like being transparent or something. I'm not sure. I'm trying to hear the lyrics. I don't have to really dissect it. I know that, but I like hearing what he says because I feel like their songwriting is brilliant. You know, when you actually hear what they're singing about, these guys are amazing. Super underrated at that. But man, see how good musicians you are. You can pick out every single instrument and tone and singer and all the things. It's so clean. These guys are so good. I love their drummer. This band is just amazing. Go. Sean's a screamer. If that's Sean, usually the bassist does that, but this is a. I'm so sorry. I know their names. I'm drawing a blank on all of them except Simone for some reason, because I've introduced his band now twice. But regardless, this has to be Sean. So he's a screamer. This is fantastic. Why not? Let's go. They're all wearing the same thing. This is weird. And one's running away. He doesn't want to be ultraviolet. This almost feels like one of those go out and find your color or something. Don't just blend in with the crowd. I don't know. We're going to find this out. This is a very, very interesting song there. Oh, God, I love them. See how good they are. A Voyager, just you never know what you're going to get. It changes 5 or 6 times throughout one song. Just the tempo, the mood, the heaviness, the lyrics. It's just like it's these guys. I love prog rock. It just keeps you on your toes. And these dudes obviously made a killing in Eurovision. But stick around for a couple minutes. Let's try to dig into what this one meant. And I will reintroduce the band to you one more time. Hey, everybody. Welcome back. This is the wrap-up to Voyager Ultraviolet. Guess what? I found some information. I'm excited to share with you. Okay. So this is from theprp.com. Good news is Voyager's new single Ultraviolet has just made its way online and finds the Australian prog metalers joined by Sean Harmonis. He's the vocalist of metalcore outfit Make Them Suffer. So that makes sense because he had that harsh, that screamer voice there. A music video for the track was shot with director Matt Pitcher and is available for viewing below. We already just watched it. Ultraviolet is certainly one of the darkest songs on the album. Oh, the album, check it out. The album that this is on, which is a very recent release, is called Fearless in Love, and it came out 2 months ago. By the time you see this, I believe, I could be wrong, but Promise is on there. Actually, I don't know if Promise is on there. Promise should be on there. It's at the bottom here. I am bouncing all over the place for you. Promise is on there. Prince of Fire is on there, which is the last reaction I did from Voyager. And this song, Ultraviolet, is on there. Back over to what this means. It's certainly one of the darkest songs of the album as the protagonist struggles to cope with the pressures of the modern world and its insane demands. The song has a message that we hope will resonate with many people, and we collaborated with director Matt Pitcher to tell this story in a cinematic way. Due to the nature of the track, we decided to enlist our good friend and fellow Australian Sean Harmonis, vocalist of metalcore band Make Them Suffer, to perform a guest vocal spot and really portray the unsettling emotion we want to communicate in the track, and he totally does. But I still feel like the bassist could have done that because he's got a phenomenal scream voice, but maybe they were looking for a specific tone, and I'm sure he was absolutely okay with that. Throughout the story, the deteriorating relationship, Ultraviolet delves into the human experience with a modern era, exploring themes of depression, social media, phone addiction, identity, and individualism. Much like the elusive yet dangerous nature of ultraviolet light, these often unforeseen forces hold immense power in shaping the course of our existence. Wow. I knew it. See, when I was listening to this, I know there's deeper meaning because these guys are absolutely brilliant with their writing, and I love everything about them. Who are they? Since I seem to have forgotten all their names, even though I've introduced them before. Lead singer is Danny Estrin. He plays vocals. He also plays the guitar, which unfortunately we didn't get to see. I don't remember hearing it in the song, but it doesn't mean he has to play it all the time. So this is Danny Estrin here. And then lead guitar, the one I did know, this is Simone Dow here. And then the bass is Alex. This is Alex Kenyon here, and he's got a phenomenal voice. He's such a goofball, but I just love listening to him play and do the heavies. Usually he does the heavies in the background, the heavy voices. I mean, there's your bass player on lead guitar. The other good-looking bald guy, this is Scott. Scott K, I'm sorry, right there on the guitar. And then my dude, Ashley, over here on the drums. He is so fun to watch and play. We didn't get to see a whole lot of the band members playing. It was more telling the story, and that's probably why they have such a phenomenal director there. But that is Voyager. Do me a favor. What'd y'all think? I haven't heard a song from them I do not like yet. They are such a phenomenal band. Great writers, great performers, and that song is 100% going on my list. And hey, if this is your first time here checking out this channel, number one, welcome. Number two, dig around. There's a few other songs I've done from Voyager, not just from Eurovision. Like I said, I did Prince of Fire as well. And I'm going to continue following them regardless how popular they are or not in the world yet. But it's just, I want to like push them out and let other people discover them because I think they're a phenomenal band. And if you like what you see, do me a huge favor. Hit that subscribe button. Everybody watching this, I also need you to do me a favor. Like this video and then ring that little bell for notifications if you are a new subscriber so you'll be notified when new videos come out from me. There are multiple ways to support me in this channel. You go to the About Me section on my page or in the video description here. I have a few links that you can click on and track. I have a PayPal button where you can leave a donation or a tip to help this channel make money. Not all videos get monetized, so this actually helps a lot of YouTubers, you know, trying to figure out other ways to get revenue from doing these videos out there. I also have a Twitter account, so you can follow me on Twitter, which basically just announces when videos come out, and I also do some things on the side from Twitter. I do have a Discord channel. You can follow me at Discord, and we can chat on the side in there because I do have that, and if you want to talk, we're on Discord, plus all the followers, you know, the whole community there. And I think it's the community that I love about this the most on there. And I actually have a Spotify playlist. So if you have a Spotify account, jump on over, like this Spotify playlist. It's called Dane Bramage Rocks, and all the songs that I react to, at least the ones that I like a lot, make it on that playlist. So you can listen to what I'm listening to, and you can listen to what's on this channel if you like what you hear so far. But everybody, I appreciate the support regardless. That was Voyager with their song Ultraviolet, came on off their latest released album, and I hope you all enjoyed it. Leave me a comment below, and all have a wonderful day, and as always, keep on rocking.